Dear friends, I'm Dr. Santosh Desai and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to discuss a very important topic, Laplace transformation. So first we will see what is meant by transformation. So transformation is a mathematical operator which transforms one form of the function into another form. So that mathematical operator is called as the Laplace transformation. For example, one can take derivative. If you take the derivative of sine x, it changes to cos x. So one can say that derivative is a transformation. So similarly, here we are going to study Laplace transformation. Now this Laplace, it is named after famous mathematician Perry-Simon Laplace. Now first we will see definition. So now, to define the Laplace transformation, we need one function. So let us take, let f of t be a function of t, defined for all t greater than equal to 0. So that is, f of t is defined for all positive values of t. Then, Laplace transformation of f of t is denoted by L of f of t and is given by so the first we take one function f of t which is defined for all t greater or equal to 0 and we use the notation L of f of t to denote the Laplace transformation of f of t and it is given by the improper integer Laplace transformation of f of t is equal to. So this is the integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So to find the Laplace transformation of given any function, first we multiply that function by e raised to minus st and then integrate from 0 to infinity. So, if this integral exists, then you can say that Laplace transformation of the given function exists. So, therefore, we put the condition providing integral exists. Okay. So, to find the Laplace transformation of a given function, of any given function which is defined for all t greater or equal to 0, first, we multiply that function by e raised to minus st and then integrate from 0 to infinity. And simplify this integral, you will get the Laplace transformation of the given function f of t. Now, here we have to note two things. So, first one, if you check this RHS, RHS contains one more variable, so that is s. So, this s is called parameter. S is called parameter. So it may be real or complex. Now one more thing again you can observe. If you find the integration of this function e raised to minus st f of t, your answer will contain two variables, s and t. And again, you have to substitute limit in place of t. So, you remains only this integral, the value of this integral only in terms of s. So, therefore, this RHS, that is this integral, is a function of s only. So, briefly, we write Laplace transformation of f of t is equal to f bar of s. And this is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So these are the two things you have to remember. So one more thing, in some books, some authors use the symbol p instead of this s. So as this is a parameter, you can use p or you can use any other symbols also. Now let us see one example based on the definition. Now how to use the definition to find the Laplace transformation of a given function. So let us take one example. Find Laplace transformation of f of t where f of t is equal to here you have to find the Laplace transformation of the function f of t, where the function f of t is given in the two parts. It is a t minus 1 in the interval 1 to 2, and the value of the function is f of t, it is equal to 3 minus t in the interval 2 to 3. And now to find out the Laplace transformation of this function. So here we know only definition of Laplace transformation. So let us apply the definition and find out the Laplace transformation of this given function. So let us see solution. So by definition, Laplace transformation of f of t is equal. Now you know only definition, that is 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So this is 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Now here we observe that the function f of t is defined in the two intervals. One is 1 to 2 and one more is 2 to 3. So the two intervals are there. So therefore we have to split this integral 0 to infinity into two parts. Now the question is, what is the value of the function f of t in the remaining part? So in the remaining parts means 0 to 1 and 3 onwards. So it is not defined, that means you have to take that value is equal to 0. So the function is defined in the two intervals. So let us split this integral into two parts. So this is equal to, first part is integration 1 to 2 e raised to minus st f of t dt plus, and second part is 2 to 3 e raised to minus st 3 minus t, sorry, this is f of t dt. So you will get the two parts. In the remaining parts, the value of the function is 0 and integration also equals to 0. Now let us substitute the values of the function in the corresponding intervals. So this is equal. First part, this is 1 to 2 e raised to minus st, and the value of the function f of t in the interval 1 to 2, that is t minus 1. Plus, in the interval 2 to 3, the value of the function is 3 minus t. So here we get e raised to minus st, 3 minus t. Now, we have to integrate this function. Now, for the integration purpose, I am going to use UV rule. So let us first recall that UV rule and then we take the integration. So let us write U rule here. So integration of UV dx is equal to. So here you have to put conditions on U and V. So first of all, this U should be algebraic. Algebraic with positive powers. With positive power. And this V should be any function whose successive integrations you can easily find out. So if this is the case, U into V, where U is the algebraic with positive powers and V is any function of x such that whose successive integrations can be easily determined, then the integration of U V dx is obtained as First you write the function u, that is as it is, and take the integration of second function and I denote it by v1. So let us see once again. First you write the given function u as it is, and then take the integration of the second function. So I denote it by v1. Now put the next sign minus. So remember that alternative plus minus sign you have to take. Again you have two functions. Take the derivative of first, I will denote it by u dash, and take the integration of second, so it is p2. Again we have two functions, next sign is plus, take the derivative of first, that is u double dash, integration of second, that is p3, minus, continue this process, and after finite steps, this process will end. Now the question is, how this process ends after finite steps? The reason is, u is algebraic with positive power. For example, if you take u is equal to x square, and what we are taking here, we are taking the derivatives of u, and the power is positive, and therefore after finite steps, for example, if u is equal to x square, your first derivative will be 2x, then you will get 2, and then you will get 0. So therefore, after finite steps, the process ends and you will get the integration. I hope it is clear. Now, let us apply this rule to find out the integration of this one. So here we take u is equal to, let us take this t minus 1, this is equal to u, and one can find the integrations of this. So let us take p is equal to e raised to minus st. Similarly for this function also, let us take u is equal to 3 minus t and e raised to minus st is equal to p, and apply this rule so you will get it. So this is equal to, let us apply rule for, so first I have to write u, that is t minus 1, and integration of e raised to minus st. So it is e raised to minus st divided by minus s. Next sign is minus, then derivative of t minus 1. Here you have to take derivative with respect to t. Derivative of t minus 1, that will be 1. And integration of e raised to minus st upon minus s, that is, you will get e raised to minus st divided by s square. Now next sign is plus, derivative of 1, that will be 0. So that the process ends, and this completes the integration, and limits are 1 to 2. One more integration is there, so put the plus, and then let us take the integration of second. So first you have to write u. U is nothing but 3 minus p, then integration of e raised to minus st, that is e raised to minus st divided by minus s. Next sign is minus, derivative of 3 minus t, that is minus 1. So I write inside the bracket, and again integration of e raised to minus st upon s minus s. So you will get, this is e raised to minus st divided by s square. Next sign is again plus, derivative of minus 1, that will be 0. So this completes the integration, and therefore the limits are 2 to 3. So simple integration one can find by using this u rule. Now let us simplify this inner brackets first. So this is equal. So if you simplify inner brackets, the first term will be, this is minus of t minus 1 e raised to minus st divided by s. Then next is, this is minus 1 into e raised to minus st upon s square. So here you will get, and limits are 1 to 2. And simplify similarly this one. So plus, simplifying this, you will get, this is minus 3 minus t e raised to minus st divided by s. This minus and minus becomes plus. So this is e raised to minus st divided by s square. And limits are 2 to 3. Now we substitute opposite and lower limit. So let us simplify this first bracket. So this is equal to, so if you put the upper limit t is equal to 2 first. So t is equal to 2, 2 minus 1, that is 1. So we will get this is minus e raised to minus 2s divided by s, then minus e raised to minus 2s divided by s square. So this completes the upper limit. For the lower limit, let us put minus and put t is equal to 1. So if you put t is equal to 1 in the first term, you will get 0. This term will be 0. Then minus, here you will get e raised to minus s divided by s square. So plus. So this is the value of the first bracket. Now let us consider that second term. So plus. Now first we put upper limit. So if you put t is equal to 3, again you will get this term reduces to 0. So it is 0. Then here you will get e raised to minus 3s upon s square. So plus e raised to minus 3s divided by s square. Now next, for lower limit, let us put minus sign and put t is equal to 2. So you will get this minus 3 minus 2, it is 1. So e raised to minus 2s divided by s plus e raised to minus 2s divided by s square. Now simplify this and that is the required final Laplace transformation. So this is equal to, now I remove all the brackets, so you will get minus e raised to minus 2s divided by s, this term as it is, minus e raised to minus 2s upon s square, this minus and minus becomes plus e raised to minus s divided by s square, here is the one more term, plus e raised to minus 3s divided by s square. Again this minus becomes plus e raised to minus 2s divided by s, and this is minus and plus, you will get minus e raised to minus 2s upon s square. Now cancelling the terms, so we get, now one can check here, this e raised to minus 2s, this cancels with e raised to minus 3s upon s. Then again, is there any other term? So one more term is there. Okay, so there is no other terms. So therefore the required answer is, this is minus e raised to minus 2s upon s square. The next term is, sorry, this one more term is here. So it is two times, then plus e raised to minus s divided by s square, and here plus e raised to minus es divided by s square. So this is the Laplace transformation of the given function. So one can use simple definition to find out the Laplace transformation of given functions. So I hope it is clear. Simple calculations are there. So you remember the procedure how to find out the Laplace transformation by using the definition only. So let us consider one more example. So find the Laplace transformation of f of t, where f of t is equal to. So this is sin t in the interval 0, t less than pi, and this is equal to 0 if t is greater than pi. So let us simplify this one. Again, so in this example also, in this example again the function is defined again in the two parts. So you have to again use the definition. So by definition, you will get Laplace of f of t is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus s t f of t dt. So this is definition. Now you check the given function. Again the functions are defined in the two parts, one is 0 to pi and t greater than pi. So you have to split integral again into two parts. One is 0 to pi and second one is pi to infinity. So this is equal to integration 0 to pi e raised to minus s t f of t dt plus integration pi to infinity e raised to minus s t f of t. So you get this one. Now next part is, you have to put the corresponding values of the functions f of t. So this is equal to integration 0 to pi e raised to minus minus s t. The value of f of t in the interval 0 to pi, that is sin t, d plus integration 0 to pi e raise to minus s t, sorry, it is pi to infinity. So in the interval pi to infinity, the value of the function f of t is 0. So 0 into t. Now obviously this integral reduces to 0. The value of this integral is 0. So therefore we demonstrate integration 0 to pi e raise to minus s t sin t dt. Now the question is how to simplify this integral, because here u rule not works, because one is an exponential function, one is a trigonometric function. So u rule definitely not works, but there is a one standard formula. So let us recall that standard formula first. So I write the formula here. It is e raised to at sin bt dt is equal to. So the integration of e raised to at sin bt dt is equal to, this is e raised to at divided by a square plus b square into bracket a into sin bt minus b into cos bt. So you have to use this formula. Now let us compare both the integrals. Let us compare this integral with this integral. And you just comparing, you will get the value of a. So here you will get value of a is equal to minus s. You can check here e raised to at is there, and here e raised to minus st. So obviously the value of a is minus s. And here sin bt and here sin t is there. So therefore b is equal to 1. So let us put a is equal to minus s, b is equal to 1 in this formula and rewrite we get. So this is equal to e raised to minus st divided by s square plus 1. Because the value of a is minus s, minus s square is again s, so you get s square. B is 1, so it is 1. Into the value of a is minus s, so it is minus s into sin t minus b is 1 into cos t. And the limits are 0 to pi. Limits are 0 to pi. Let us put upper and lower limit. So this is equal to, just I put upper limit first. So we get e raised to minus pi s divided by s square plus 1 into. Now s into sin pi. The value of sin pi is 0. So this first term will be 0. Then minus cos pi. Cos pi is minus 1. So here you get minus 1. So this is the value of upper limit. Now for the lower limit, let us take negative minus. Put t is equal to 0. So you get 1 upon s square plus 1. 1 upon s square plus 1 into t is equal to 0. So you get sin 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. And simplify this, you will get the required answer. So this is equal to this minus and this minus becomes plus. So here you will get e raised to minus pi s divided by s square plus 1. And here again minus minus becomes plus. So this is 1 divided by s square plus 1. So the denominators are same. So you put the denominator and you just add the numerators. So this is e raised to minus pi s plus 1. So this is the required Laplace transformation of the given function f of t. So by using definition, you can find the Laplace transformation. So in the next lecture, we will see some standard Laplace. Laplace transformations of some standard elementary functions, and then we will see some properties of Laplace transformation. So thank you so much for it. Thank you so much for watching. Please, for more videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank
Thank you. Thank you so much.